Sweet peppers and chili peppers belong to the Solanaceae family.
The genus Capsicum includes five cultivated species: Capsicum baccatum, Capsicum chinense, Capsicum frutescens, Capsicum pubescens.
The vast majority of cultivated varieties belong to the Capsicum annuum species, of which there are thousands of varieties,
including sweet peppers, mild chili peppers, and very spicy chilies.
There is a great diversity in size, shape, and color of peppers. Pollination.
The flowers of pepper plants are hermaphrodite and self-fertilizing, which means that the male and female organs are in the same flower and are compatible. They are therefore autogamous. The flowers can, however, also be fertilized by pollinating insects, such as bumblebees and bees.
They are sensitive to changes in temperature. If at night the temperature is too high, 29 degrees centigrade, or too low, 5 degrees, the flowers will fail, meaning they will not be pollinated. As a consequence, the peppers will have few or no seeds, which will greatly influence the size of the fruit. The best fructification is when night temperatures vary between 12 and 16 degrees centigrade.
To encourage self-fertilization, you can regularly shake the plants during the flowering season. All species of the Capsicum genus can cross-pollinate, with the exception of the Capsicum pubescens species.
To avoid cross-pollination between two varieties in temperate climates, leave 100 meters between them. This distance can be reduced to 50 meters if there is a natural barrier such as a hedge.
In tropical climates, keep 1 kilometer between two varieties and 500 meters if there is a hedge. To avoid cross-pollination by insects, you can also isolate plants using nets, either in a tunnel or under a permanent mosquito net. But watch out, peppers need a lot of light. Too tight and restrictive cages will hinder plant development and reduce fruit and seed production. See the module on mechanical isolation techniques in the ABC of seed production.
Life cycle.
Peppers are annual plants in most cases, but some species are perennial in tropical climates. It is a plant that needs a lot of heat to develop well. Peppers grown for their seeds are cultivated in the same way as those for food.
Grow 6 to 12 plants of each variety to ensure good genetic variety. Once the flower is in bloom, it will take between 60 and 100 days, depending on the variety, for the fruit to be ready for consumption.
The plants you select for seed production should be the healthy and vigorous ones that you have been able to observe throughout their growth and that correspond to the desired selection criteria.
For the plants, you should look for regular and strong growth, numerous flowers, a good fructification, and branches that do not break. For the fruits, look for the best tasting ones, the variety's typical shape, size, color, and thickness of the flesh and the skin.
You should avoid extracting seeds from already harvested peppers, as this does not enable you to check all of the characteristics linked to the growth of the variety. To harvest the seeds, wait until full maturity. The green fruit will have become red, brown, orange, or yellow. The pale yellow fruits will have turned dark yellow, orange, or red. At this stage, the seeds are yellow and are mature.
Don't pick the seeds of immature fruits, as their germination capacity will be much lower. It is best to harvest the seeds from the first ripe fruits of a plant. Those taken from later fruit tend to have a lower germination rate. Never harvest seeds from sick peppers. Extracting, sorting, storing.
Watch out! It is important to extract spicy chili seeds in a well-ventilated place, and if possible outside, to avoid emanations of capsaicin. These can induce eye, throat, and nose irritations.
It is also important to use thick rubber gloves and even safety goggles.
Cut the peppers in two and remove the seeds using a knife. Place them in a bowl full of water. The empty seeds will float. Remove them with a sieve.
Finish cleaning the good seeds in the sieve under running water. It is then important to dry the seeds within 2 days.
To do that, place them on a fine meshed sieve or a plate in a dry, airy, and warm place, between 23 and 30 degrees centigrade.
Another method for small quantities is to dry them on coffee filters, as they are very absorbing and the seeds do not stick to them. Place at most a small teaspoon of seeds on each filter and write the name of the variety and the species on the filter using a marker pen. Hang the sachets on a clothes rack in a dry, airy, shaded and warm place. Avoid exposing the seeds to the sun, and don't dry them on paper to which they could stick.
Write the name of the variety and species, as well as the year, on the label and place it inside the sachet. Writing on the outside often rubs off.
A few days in the freezer will kill any parasite larvae.
The germination capacity of chili and pepper seeds is 3 to 6 years.
To lengthen it, keep the seeds in the freezer.